And welcome back, everyone, to Live at 9. Born and raised in New Orleans, Louisiana. Did I say that right?
Yeah,
New Orleans.
I love how you said that, too.
This next guest, no stranger to good food. He grew up, Dreux Antoine developed not only a love for music, entertainment, but also the culinary arts.
And that passion sparked a number of ideas, including his launch of the Soulful Chef Company. Well, now he's out with a cookbook and wants to bring this tasty dish to the masses. So let's welcome the Soulful Chef to the Live at 9 kitchen this morning. Now, we know you're triple threat, as we teased it. You sing, you do everything, but you're here cooking today.
I am here.
So how'd you start cooking? I mean, I know you do a lot of things, but where's the passion from in cooking?
So I'm the little boy that grew up in the kitchen with grandmother. Mm. I come from a family of restaurateurs and cooks, so it just kind of trickled down from generation to generation. So when I saw grandmother in the kitchen, I just took interest in that, and I just was the little boy always on her heels watching her cook for the family. If you've ever seen the movie Soul Food, mm-hmm. or the series,
yeah.
That's us. Every Sunday our family would get together and we would have Sunday dinner, but I spent the weekends with grandmother, so I actually helped her cook, and I had to take the credit for it as well too.
I hear that accent too, by the way.
Is there a certain style of cooking that you enjoy more than us? I mean, I think we're about to get into some pasta here, so mm-hmm. you might say this is a little bit more of an Italian food, but there has to be a huge blend of food sources and types from the New Orleans area, and everybody seems to love the food out of New Orleans.
Absolutely, and that's one of the advantages. Growing up around the Cajun and the Creole, it kind of helps to diversify with adding on and doing fusion-inspired dishes. So we have something called Yakimen in New Orleans, which of course is an Asian dish, mm-hmm. but we put the New Orleans twist on it, so it becomes just like this New Orleans-infused Asian cuisine. And it's also in the cookbook as well, and that's just really one of the advantages of having that background in Creole and Cajun. You can kind of infuse it into different categories.
Well, why don't we get started here. Yeah, as you're putting some things together, tell us what it is that you're doing.
So this is a very simple dish that I call spaghetti pasta. It's typically made with spaghetti noodles, but mm-hmm. you can diversify it and do it with any type of pasta noodles that you like. Mm-hmm. So today we're trying it with the rotini pasta, which of course is one of my favorites because it comes out looking delicious. And it's very, very simple to make.
And it looks great, too.
And I can smell it, too.
I mean, come on.
Good.
So the mayonnaise, the roasted pimento peppers, the olives is actually what gives it the flavor. The dry season is just added on.
Okay.
So here we have the cooked spaghetti noodle, cooked rotini pasta noodles here. We're just going to add in about a spoonful and a half of mayo.
Nice.
Now the cookbook calls for a cup and a half because that's for 6 to 8 servings. So just depending on how many you're serving determines how much ingredients you're going to add.
I love the way you do that right there in the pot. You don't dirty up another dish. That sounds just like my mom.
Yeah.
Hey, look.
Save on time, save on dish, save on everything.
Absolutely.
So this is one of the pasta dishes that are actually served hot or cold. You can do it hot or
right.
cold.
Mm-hmm.
So then once you add in your mayo, you'll go ahead and then you'll get in your olives. So if you're a big olive person, you can add in the olives and the juice just to give it that
flavor. I was just about
flavor.
To ask you about the juice, too.
Yeah. But if of course, if you're seeing it that it's a little bit too watery, of course, then you reduce the amount of liquids that you're putting in.
That's real easy. Just mixes right up.
And then you'll go ahead and add in your roasted pimento peppers. And again, depending on how many you're serving, determines how much you want to put in.
Real quickly, where do you get that? I mean, I'm gathering, did you make that yourself, or is that something?
So yeah, you can actually roast the red bell pepper and then fire grill it or fire saute it really until it kind of has like that charred taste to it.
I was gonna say, does it have like a kick?
Yeah, so it has that kick. It gives it that kick. It gives it that nice hard
that you like, New Orleans.
That I like. That I like.
Things like onion powder, garlic salt, anything like that. That's more to taste, right?
Right. So and that's what's in the cookbook too. We say season to taste because we know people love it different ways, salty, mm-hmm. peppery, whatever. So we just add it in for added flavors, and then we just top it off with our dry parsley flakes, and then
that was like 2 minutes and it's finished.
That's
right?
It, and that's it. You serve your family, and that's it.
That's
and
right.
You'll just let it cook down, and it'll thicken up and become a nice creamy texture.
Now here's the big question: how did it go from cooking to singing and cooking at the same time?
So I started music first.
Right.
I started singing at age 4. I started piano at age 8. I didn't actually get into the family's kitchen probably until I was 12 in New Orleans. That's probably late. But 12, I was coming home from school, and the restaurant was right there on the way home.
And we're going to get to hear you sing in just a little bit.
Yeah,
fantastic.
Yeah.
So don't go anywhere. We're going to be coming back in just a few minutes.
Absolutely.
Awesome.